Start by cleaning your hands with soap and water or alcohol-based hand gel. Clean your work surface with soap and water or a disinfecting wipe. Gather the equipment and supplies you need: a cough assist device, a filter, a piece of corrugated tubing, an adapter, non-sterile gloves, a patient interface, such as a mouthpiece face mask or trach tube adapter, and a suction machine and supplies, if the patient uses one. Identify a signal the patient can use if they need to stop the session. Put on the non-sterile gloves. If the patient uses a suction machine, check to make sure it is functioning properly. Starting at the cough assist device, assemble the filter, corrugated tubing, adapter, and patient interface. Turn on the cough assist machine. Check that the settings on the device match those prescribed by the healthcare provider. Block the end of the tubing or cover the mask with your gloved hand. Push the therapy or start button. You should see both positive and negative pressures on the display screen. Once you see both, the check is complete. Push the standby button. If the patient does not use a trach tube, put the mouthpiece or mask on the patient. If using a mask, make sure the patient's chin is up and the mask forms a tight seal on the face. If the patient has a tracheostomy, attach the adapter to the trach tube. If it is a cuffed trach tube, check the patient's care plan. Typically, cough assist therapy requires that the cuff be inflated to maintain pressure in the airway. Push the therapy or start button to start the session. Allow the device to give the prescribed number of inhalation and exhalation cycles, usually 4 to 6. Monitor the patient's color, heart rate, and comfort level during the cycles. You may stop the therapy if the patient becomes uncomfortable, needs to cough, or needs to be suctioned. After the prescribed number of cycles, allow the device to provide inhalation pressure one more time, then quickly remove the mouthpiece, mask, or adapter. Push the standby button on the device. Allow the patient to rest and breathe normally for 30 seconds to 1 minute. The patient may cough, huff cough, or be suctioned during this time if needed. Repeat the inhalation and exhalation cycles, followed by a rest period as prescribed by the healthcare provider. Remember to allow the device to provide inhalation pressure one last time before starting the rest period. When the therapy session is complete, turn off the cough assist device. Encourage the patient to breathe deeply and cough or huff cough. If the patient has a suction machine, use it to clear secretions from the trach tube or back of the throat if needed. Regularly clean cough assist tubing, mouthpieces, masks, and trach adapters to prevent respiratory infection. Wash the mouthpiece or trach adapter in warm water and standard dish soap after each use. Rinse with warm water and air dry. Wipe the mask with a clean cloth dampened with warm soapy water after each use. Once a week, wash the mask and tubing in warm water and standard dish soap, then rinse with warm water and air dry. Replace the filter on the cough assist device once a month or sooner if it is visibly dirty. After finishing therapy and cleaning the supplies, remove the non-sterile gloves and clean your hands.